I believe in the flag of the United States of America and to the republic which stands one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'd like to thank everyone for the meeting. We will do roll call. Diane.
Mr. Douglas.
Here.
Mr. Irwin.
Here.
Mr. McDonald.
Here. We also have Matt, our attorney. We also have Bob, our code officer. We also have Dave, our dog control officer. We have Mike, our highway superintendent. We have Pam, our secretary to the board. We have Courtney just walking in, water and sewer. And we have Jim Kirby, justice. And our health residents. Okay, we're gonna move on. Need a number four. I need a motion and a second for approval of the minutes of April 9th, 2018 regular board meeting.
I'll make it.
Jim Douglas made it.
Second.
Now second. Any discussion? It all look good, like always. Everyone in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All three ayes, it passes. Community input. Anyone sign up, Diane?
Yes. Joseph.
Lucio.
Yo, thank you. Would you like to share about the kids' project, potential student project?
Yeah, I don't want to speak too much because the kids are running the whole project.
And they're going to come May 14th, too.
Yeah, and they wanted to come tonight, but you know, we just kind of found out that we were invited today. They couldn't get everything together, and you know, some of the kids had a softball game, so I just figured I'd pop in to answer any questions that you have about the project.
Yeah, I know Mel had a couple questions about the project along the trail, Mel. They asked as well.
Nothing major. I'm just curious about the distances. What it's relative to the plant's placement.
Yeah, so the idea is, you know, as people are walking through, there's some signage, and the planets are to scale in terms of size and distance. It's the same scale. It should just give people kind of a sense of how tiny we are and how vast the solar system is. You know, the kids have talked about getting, you know, community businesses involved and that sort of thing. But we're pretty open-ended. They've been working out designs for signs. So if there's any way that you guys can have some kind of a liaison or something along those lines to work with the kids. They're a sharp group of kids. They're like accelerated eighth grade earth science students. And we're collaborating with the technology department. We're using some of the great tools that they've got at the school, the 3D printers, laser engraver, vinyl cutter. So really, whatever you guys want for signs, as long as we've got the ability to create it, we can make that work for you. If there's a certain theme that you want to have for the signs, the kids will work with you. They're doing graphic design and technology. They're modeling things in CAD programs, so it can be really, however big and involved you want it to be.
Good. I just sent her an email today when I got here too. If you guys want me to go over to school, or if you guys want to come here during the week, like I told her, the whole board will meet on May 14th next, and you guys can do your presentation then. But everyone was on board. Just would like to, you know, kind of see what the scope of it was.
Yeah, so they're just looking because, you know, as soon as they can get kind of, you know, approved on things, they can move forward and start the construction process. Because, you know, we're only in school until mid-June, so we'd like to get the whole thing wrapped up.
Absolutely.
Great.
Thank you.
Next. Back.
One report back on our meeting with the banners and flag issue. I think bottom line is it'll be a cold day in Helmick where we easily get the zoning ordinance changed, which then it's like toss it back to the town. What do they want? In the current zoning ordinance, we have some workarounds. I'm pretty sure I read, I don't know if I can find it, looking for it. We can put up patriotic flags. So we can all put up American flags and use them as open signs. I don't want to do that. I don't think that's how a flag should be used. But we can do it according to the zoning regs. We can come up with events of significance every 30 days, and Bob can spend his time arguing on what is an event of significance. Or we can come up with something like and I don't know the proper term, we're going to put a moratorium, we're going to put enforcement on hold, we're going to study it, we're going to put restrictions on flags per road frontage. We can, I've got a list of things I thought of. You can limit it to retail and restaurants because that's the businesses that the flags are important for, not the businesses that depend on appointment traffic, don't need, you know, a fluttering flag. It's late to have like a student intern do it, but maybe somehow we could pull together doing some sort of study. We put the flags up for a week, we take them down. We put them up, we take them down. We track our sales and traffic and see, is there an impact? You know, we can do that for however many months. If the town, it's really up to the town of how you want us as business people to proceed.
The only question I have is why Elizabeth has not chosen to put a sign up at all, a permanent sign. I mean, I pose that to you. I mean, it's, you don't have anything to compare it to. If you had a permanent sign there, what would that not make a difference?
I have not. Well, that'll be another issue to do with zoning on us. For me to put a permanent sign, I either have to put it across the ditch, which gets in the way of highway mowing, or I have to put it where it interferes with traffic flow, which means that to meet the zoning thing, I need to grass in some of my field and move the farm stand back, so I can't qualify for a relief on that. I've asked Bob, I said, I'd like to take my double-sided 24-foot square sign, instead of having a piece of plywood with sign sandwiched on each side, put one on each end of my farm stand, 16-inch farm stand. I can't do that.
I mean, I can only enforce what's in the code.
Yeah, right.
And if that's two signs, that's two sides. I mean, it says building sign, you're allowed one building sign. And I can't, you know, I explained to you the amendment procedure in the code that you need to follow.
Right,
in order
and,
to
I,
amend
and
the code.
I just said I won't.
Okay.
But the signs and the banners are two different issues. Signage announces that you're there.
Okay.
Banners welcome you. Banners invite you in.
But I think that the code is pretty clear, the definition of sign,
right.
that the banners, streamers, they're all, you know, the streamers and flutterers, they're prohibited inside in the code. So
Well, it's a matter of also, I'm not saying on enforcement, but attitude of does the town want to actually look at it? If we're going to have business-friendly ordinances, does the town want to say, okay,
so you want to selectively enforce the code?
No. For this summer, we're going to say we're not going to enforce it, and the people who have the flags are going to participate in tracking sales and things when they have, and we're going to do some sort of organized, you're up for a period of time, you're down for a period, you're up, you're down, so you have something of the impact other than just the first time putting them up, so you find out whether it matters. I did try to look online for studies. All I got was banner ads on the internet. I talked to a professor at SUNY Plattsburgh. She couldn't find much. She got one research thing that was a lot of surveys and citing a lot of other sign things, but it was signs. It wasn't banners and flags. So there just is not much out there from what we say, other than, and I'm sure it's there from the people who sell banners and flags, and they say it's important. That's probably not your credible source. There's not much data out there other than experience of people saying they make a huge difference. So I said, we can get around it.
But again, I go back to, if you had a sign in place.
No, signs do not work for.
It doesn't.
They announce you're there. They announce you exist, and if people are not going 65 miles an hour, they may actually read it. Signs work fairly well in pedestrian areas and in low trips. When somebody is looking for an appointment at such and such place and they're not sure where it is, and they slow down, I know it's in this block, there it is. But it's the flags and the banners that say, there's life there, there's activity, yes, I'm welcome. So I'm just, you know, sort of leave it back to the town. If we can work around it, it's not a nice workaround, or do you want to be proactive and try to come up and see whether it actually matters? Thank you.
2 points bring up that. Number one, let's make sure that we've got Rob as enforcement. He can only enforce what's on the books. Secondly, I think we should bring this up through the zoning. work with the zoning and then bring that to the town. It's frustrating, and I know where you're coming from, as frustrating as that is. I think that's the avenue we need to proceed with.
That's why we have zoning laws, and, you know, that's, I've talked to other town supervisors, and like they said, a grand opening on a banner that, you know, a flag that flaps, the streamers they call it, whatever, like you said, grand openings, that's one thing, but to have them permanent as a sign doesn't give the right look to any town, the two or three I've talked to. I haven't talked to every one of them, no, I've contacted them, but I haven't returned phone calls yet, so.
Okay, any other community input that did sign up?
Yes.
Okay, going on. Number six, discussion, approved superintendent, Dr. Thomas Palmer, regarding Parkwell project operating budget. He's gonna speak.
Appreciate the board and Brandon the opportunity to again, I thank the board for taking the opportunity and the community just a brief. I've been out, I was at the Peru Firehouse the other night. I'm here tonight in Skyler Falls tomorrow, Sable. To at least give people an opportunity that they have questions and not have opportunities to come to our board meetings. And we have two things going on right now. We have, of course, as you know, the normal school budget that's going on, that the board has come to a resolution. It's a $49 million budget. And we also have the building capital project, which are two separate pieces. The budget you're voting on this year is $49 million. We went out the maximum of the allowable tax cap at 2.1%, $357,000 increase, but unfortunately we got hit with $1,600,000 increase in health insurance loans. Health insurance went through the roof. So there's some cuts that we did have to afford this year, unfortunately, in the budget. Part-time reduction in a music position, a school counselor position. Through attrition, no real cut, but through attrition, we're not replacing one of our elementary teachers. French and English also. No one lost benefits, but we did have small reductions. And the reason why I'm here to also share with everybody is, how do you have a budget that has reductions yet you're still going out with a building project? Well, the difference is the building project, and through prudent planning before I got here, and I feel pretty good about finance, but your boards and Randy Sapp did a great job in planning, and they put away their capital reserve of $1.75 million. So what that happened was they put that in a savings account, and as this building project kept growing, they also took $700,000 out, and you'll see it outlined in the thing, for $2.4 million contribution of the local people. That's the district's contribution to the $18 million project. The rest is state aid over. So over the period of time, we'll get 88% return on the state aid. So what we're doing is, this is not a non-frill type building project. But I want to at least answer any questions. I'm not going to go through this verbatim. But just to give you the biggest thing, it's restoration. It's putting our roofs back on warranty, so roofs that are out of warranty on the building. Some classrooms, some inner design. There's no out structure except for a 4,000 square foot out parcel building for the maintenance. So that building that you see down in the corner of the baseball field is going to be replaced, and it's well overdue. The piece that the community may see the most, that's most visible, is in the last part of this project, the board elected to put in a $300,000 lighting for the football field, but we're not just using it for football. The goal is also allow soccer, the track in the springtime, so more kids will have the opportunity to use that physical plant. And the other piece that the public will see is the wrestling room. The wrestling room is approximately 24 feet in height. They're going to cut that building in half and put a 6-inch middle-level floor, and the bottom floor will be a weight room and physical facility with bathrooms and a small snack bar, and the second floor will be the weight room with a permanent mat, so the kids are going to have to pick it up, tear it down, and then they'll have mats for the gymnasium for their meets. The piece that I'm also trying to be more inviting to the public is to allow the public, one, to be able to come into the building during the school year and be able to walk at night, so you have hall walking. The other piece is the community will be able to use this weight room or physical facility at, say, 6 at 9 at night, so they'll have an opportunity to go in there at nighttime also and use the physical facility. The biggest piece, as you look through a lot of the bulleted items, the high school and elementary schools, a lot about restoration, revitalization of what we have as our physical plan, the footprint itself. Also, there's some blacktop, also possibly having a wrap around the back of the building to come around the other side. There's no artificial turf or any really fancy, frilly things. It's mostly the essentials of the building. The other part is, just so you understand, is so the $2.4 million contribution of the taxpayers through previous funds will also keep a stabilization piece for our budget. So when we retire debt service, we'll maintain that going forward. So you won't see a big spike or a decrease in the budget that way, which is good planning, good prudent planning. But I just wanted to, you know, present tonight, at least let people understand there's two separate entities going on coming up at the budget vote on Tuesday, May 15th. Anybody have anything for? Yes, sir.
I just have one question. What's the fuel source in the building now for the school?
It's natural gas.
It is natural gas.
It's natural gas. Yes.
All right, thank you.
Also, the piece you'll see also besides the two buildings is also the physical plan of the bus garage too. Some upgrades of that that's in dire straits that really needs some upgrades. So again, it's not a beautiful project, but it's a project of essential though for the district. So, any other questions?
I met with Randy Sapp that one budget meeting I went to. I was the only one there.
The only one. It was zero after that. There was nobody there.
I was the only one there at the meeting. And like I explained to him too, is Jeremiah, our new assessor for the county that's in Peru, by state funding, our state is making him raise the assessed value $12 million. That's assessed value of your houses and stuff. It's not taxes going up. It's just the assessed value of houses. Which equals about 7 to 8%.
And when ORPS gets involved, that could change that also.
Absolutely.
But it's like the perfect storm, because I didn't want to bring that up, but thank you for bringing that. That is the perfect storm. You know, people, you don't have anything you really vote on except the school budget.
Yeah.
So this is going to be the perfect whirlwind of the three pieces all coming together.
Absolutely.
So, but I want to leave, like I said, my office is always open to anybody either. If you ever want to come by, you're more than welcome. We've all the relationships again with the police agencies and the fire department. You know, it's your district. I'm here to serve you and to try to make sure that we're moving and continue to move in the right direction. So, thank you.
Thank you again.
Resolution discussion. Resolution to declare lead agency and approve secret for Telegraph Culvert 2 project. We need a motion and a second for that, and then we have to read the resolution.
I'll make that motion.
We have Bill's motion.
Second.
And Jim second. And we will have Diane read her funnel.
A resolution declaring the town as lead agency in SECRA. Negative declaration. Whereas the town board of the town of Peru is considering an application by Michael Farrell, superintendent of highways, for the replacement of an existing 6-foot diameter by 60-foot long CMP culvert that is failing, with a new 6-foot wide by 6-foot precast culvert 60 feet long as at the intersection of Telegraph Road and Sullivan Road. The proposed action. Whereas the applicant has requested the town approval of this replacement project. Whereas the proposed action is an unlisted action within the requirements of the New York State Environmental Quality Review Act. Whereas the New York State Environmental Quality Review Act requires the town to determine the lead agency status and the lead agency making a secret determination. Whereas the town of Peru agrees to assume lead agency status on April 23rd, 2018. Whereas pursuant to Article 8 of the Environmental Conservation Law and the Code of the Town of Peru, the Town Highway Department has prepared the short form environmental assessment form, which is now on file with the town board and the town SECRA officer. And whereas the town's Peru board has reviewed proposed action and on April 23rd, 2018, recommended to the town board the approval of the proposed action. Now, therefore, be it resolved as follows that the town board, as lead agency, has determined that the proposed action is an unlisted action under SECRA. The town board, as lead agency, hereby determines that the unlisted action described in the attached SECRA negative declaration notice of determination of non-significance, which attached notice is hereby made a part of this resolution, will not have a significant effect on the environment, and that an environmental impact statement is not required to be prepared with respect to the proposed action. And be it resolved that this resolution shall take effect immediately.
Any discussion? If not, roll call.
Mr. Douglas?
Yes.
Mr. Irwin?
Yes.
Mr. Langley is excused, and Mr. McDonald?
Is here, yes. Carries three votes to zero. Next one, discussion number eight, Main Street Improvement Project Update. This coming Friday, April 27th, it's going out to bid. The pre-bidding meeting is May 2nd at 10 o'clock here at the Town Hall. And the opening bid will be on May 10th, Friday, May 10th at 10 a.m. And the bid will be rewarded on May 14th at a board meeting. And so it goes from out to bid this Friday, the 27th. Pre-bidding meeting is Wednesday, May 2nd. Opening bid is May 11th, Friday. And then bid award is Monday, May 14th at our next board meeting. And that's the update for the Main Street project update. Just want to keep you all informed. Residents and everyone else. Cam, anything else to add to that? Anything else to add?
Nope.
Okay, we're going to move on to number nine. Resolution discussion, sewer collection upgrade service with AES. We need a motion and a second, and we're going to have Diane read the resolution of that one. Actually, you know what? Cam, do we have two resolutions for this?
No, I've got it right here this time. Right here.
The first one Diane did? No. Yes.
Sure. We only have number 10 for a resolution.
We're going to go to number 10.
We're going to get a motion and a second for sewer collection upgrade sewer funding. So we're going to need a motion and a second for that. Jim made the motion.
No second.
Second by Mel. And we will have you, Diane, read the resolution for that number 10.
Resolution for general savings to do an interim loan to the sewer collections upgrade project. Whereas the town of Peru Sewer is in need of an interim loan for the approved preliminary design phase of the sewer collections upgrade project. And whereas the approval of this preliminary work has resulted in the need to borrow $50,000 from town general savings. Now, be it resolved that the town general savings account is authorized to loan the amount of $50,000 to the town H26 sewer collection system account until the ESC, WIA grant, and USDA low-interest loan monies become available. Said loan to be paid back to general savings within the term of 1 year. And be it resolved that this resolution shall take effect immediately.
Any discussion on that, guys?
Do you want to tell everybody roughly what it is?
Courtney can probably describe the scope of it. It's to keep AES moving. With a big sewer project that we have going on, In 2020, we are looking at doing a major redo of our sewer system that's failing over the years. This has been going on for about 5 years now. We've been working with them roughly around 5 years. We've been working with AES, and we had a workshop for a couple hours, probably 3-4 weeks ago with AES. And like they said, to keep this moving forward, to start getting...
get our aerial mapping done.
Exactly.
A lot of stuff. We can narrow down, but we got to do our archaeological studies, our geological easement work, some survey work.
They would like to have something to move forward to get us moving along, just in case something happens. And what we're looking at is going out in 2020 to start this project, but to keep things moving along, to keep things in order to for paperwork-wise and stuff like that, for easements and stuff. Any other discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Douglas?
Yes.
Mr. Irwin?
Yes.
Mr. McDermott?
Yes.
And Mr. Langley is excused.
Yeah. Okay. All three is yes, it passes. We're going to go back to number 9. We need a motion and a second for resolution discussion on the sewer collection upgrade service with AES, which pertains to this same thing. So, a motion and a second.
A motion.
Bill made a motion.
Second.
Second by Jim. And Brian, I will have you read that resolution.
A resolution accepting the proposal from as Northeast PLLC to further the sewer collection system preliminary design work. Whereas the town of Crewe has determined that the trunk sewer system on the north side of the Little Lost Civil River is in need of repairs as outlined in the 2015 AES report titled Collection System Evaluation North of the Little Lost Civil River. And whereas the town seeks to obtain grant and low interest loan funds to assist in reducing the cost of the project to the sewer district. And whereas the town recognizes that work, generally including preparation of funding applications and documentation, preliminary survey work, preliminary and schematic engineering, archaeological work, geotechnical work to move the project forward while the town secures said grants and low interest loans is required. And whereas AES Northeast PLLC has proposed to complete all or portions of the above work for not to exceed cost of $50,000, with additional work for final design to be completed once funding is in place. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the town board accepts the proposal from AES Northeast PLLC for the above reference work, and be it resolved that this resolution shall take effect immediately.
Any discussion on that? Basically, it's the scope of work of what we just approved, the 50. This is what they are looking at going over and doing. And this is the same project that we have over $1 million grant for also when we move forward with this project. It's over $1 million that we have.
You've touched base with them and coordinate, tell them that we're going to be working on improving this so they can keep going forward. But after that meeting,
any other discussion? If not, roll call.
Mr. Douglas?
Yes.
Mr. Irwin?
Yes.
Mr. McDonald?
Yes. Okay, 3 passes. Okay, we're right to other business already. Jim?
The only thing I had this weekend, there was a couple of people that asked me, you know, that they achieved where we get that $9 million, you know, down through the driveway and all that. They wanted to learn a little bit start. Who was doing it? And
what I know about it, I talked to a guy from Verizon today after you called me about it with the question. And like he said, they have over 2 years to complete the broadband. Verizon was rewarded over, I think it was like $3 million. They're going to be upgrading over at North Bend Street, like $90,000 in that building and throughout the town. Also, PrimeLink was awarded quite a bit, but Verizon was awarded the big majority of that project for the town. They worked 2 years to do it. Has nothing, like I told a couple of people, it has nothing to do with the town itself, because the contracts go up to the people, and the state will pay them as they have it. If you look in the back, when that first ad first came out, where they were awarded $9 million, that we were awarded $9 million, it has towards the last page, it has each person, how much they were awarded of the project. So Verizon and PrimeLink, they have 2 years to complete this project.
Yeah. One of these guys had asked, he was on the condo, sold his house, built a house out towards Mark Conway. He was wondering when that would, you know, be going out.
It will be completed, like he said, by, well, it's got to be completed to get their money from the state by February 20th of 2020.
Yeah.
And any other questions I can always ask? I got a guy that comes, I work for Verizon all the time. He's very helpful. Anything else?
No.
Nope.
Diane? Nope. Brian? We had our DEC inspection of all our sewer facilities 2 weeks ago. Seemed to go good. I'm still waiting on the report. They should send you a copy also, Brandy. Sprint started their work on the water tower. Matt, just gearing up for spring.
Mike?
Village is done, barn is sweeping. We got to scope around and get our grade all back. There's some warranty work done because of spots. Where we dumped off spot ups, got to be fixed or re-ditched. Topsoil, I did meet with Don LeBlanc from Precision Technologies on the big culvert in the 600 that we just did the seed work for down the Telegraph. They can be lined, so if we don't get this funding, both culverts can be lined. In fact, I'm going to call him, give us a price and do the 6 footer. He had offered to come up and teach us how to do the 6 footer. If the 6 would work, I think that's probably the best way to go. We'll see how it plays out on the funding. Obviously, if we don't get the money, we're not going to do the dig. I do like the idea of lining it, and we don't have to mess with anything. In the seeker, the only reason I do that is when we did for the big culvert in the 6 footer, it was one project, but the Bridge New York culvert, New York people are putting it as two, so we had to do another performance. That's all it is. It's one project to us, but it's two of them. It's both in the same area.
Keeping our options open.
Yes. Yeah.
And
so,
in your estimation, the smaller culvert is more of a pressing issue than the big one?
Right now, yeah. Still got some time on the big one. I'd like to see where the funding goes. If we get it, great, and it doesn't cost it 100%. If we don't, then we'll look at that mining, and I'm sure that's not going to be cheap because it's a 10-foot culvert to bring along. And they can do it two different ways, with the plastic or galvanized again, and I'm not thrilled about the galvanized. He did call me back, said there is a 100-year warranty with this. It was supposed to be good for 100 years. I don't know if it's really a warranty, but if we get 100 years out of it, we'll all be long gone. So. So that's all I got.
Bob?
One other question, Mike. Okay. You've all said with mailboxes, there's a lot of mailboxes in my town.
Yeah, we did get quite a few. We didn't hit them, but that last ice storm this week, that stuff was wicked heavy. A lot of people thought we don't even have the wings on. I had took the wings off the week before because the ground's so soft and you're just going to tear everything up, or you're going to walk, you're going to put the wing right through the door, the direct passenger door. So people, a lot of them thought they got hit. It wasn't, it was just a plain old slush coming off. It was heavy. It just, if you shovel the end of your driveway, you know, and you got a 12-foot blade, it's half the lane of road, a lot of weight comes off.
I can tell you, me and Mike went to at least 6 of them to see to make sure that we didn't clip them. I mean, Daryl did get one.
Yeah, we did. Breaker. Actually, we did have one.
Daryl got one, and we are going to, we replaced it. So, that's that stuff is heavy.
Every once in a while, you get somebody tries to throw one in and taken out by a car. Well, it's 3-2.
I had that happen a month ago. So.
That's all I got.
Okay, Bob.
Busy, as Mike said, everybody's gearing up. 5 applications for the planning board at the next meeting, so that's pretty strong. We're busy, so a lot going on.
Thank you, Bob. Today I had to call Bob because Saturday I got a call at midnight of a noise complaint here on Main Street.
and the state troopers met me at the house, and Bob Lana already delivered a notice of next time there's a violation like that, that they're going to be fined and have a court appearance. So thank you for doing that so fast. Dave.
Nothing I dare to talk about.
Nothing?
Nothing.
Okay, Pam. Okay, Jim.
Just to give everybody the heads up, there's a trial coming up first part of May, and it will be kind of crazy over there as far as parking. And so if you get calls, complaints, that's what's going on. And I probably should, Mr. Palmer is involved with school, so the buses may have an issue of going down, picking up on daily. And last time I went over to bus garage and talked to Dave, and I gave him the heads up the day before, and that actually that trial didn't happen, but so it wasn't really an issue, but this one may be an issue. So I appreciate it.
Anything else, Kim?
No, I'm good.
Well, thank you. I have a couple of things. Other business, Mike and Pam met with a state representative a little over 2 weeks ago, and we already have that funding to the town already for the storm of July 12th of 2017. We got a check for $21,875.45 already, so that came be really fast from the state. So that's good. We have that in there. Other business, what else do I have? Gene's 85th birthday today, so happy birthday, Gene.
I have to say.
We should come to a town board meeting. Thank you. Other than that, I think that's all I have for other business. We're going to go discussion for the public comments on agenda items only. Any comments?
I think I'll follow up. I mentioned to you before the meeting, and I don't know if that Main Street project can be done before the Apple Fest, but if it's underway and things are torn up during the Apple Fest, we could have a lot of chaos out here.
Yeah, and we can discuss that for sure. We know the dates of the Apple Fest, so we can definitely discuss it and make sure we're somewhat. Yeah.
And I've seen the plans for that, Randy. That should be done way ahead of that.
Oh, really?
For a contractor, that's not much of a project.
We can make that prerequisite in that contract.
Yeah.
We can mention that.
Well, we will for sure. Well, like Mike said, it should be done. I mean, it shouldn't take someone a long time to do it, but make sure we talk about it. Thanks, Joe. Anything else?
Is there a time frame on that?
It's got to be done by the end of the year.
By the end of the year?
Yeah. It's got to be done by the end of the year. Yep. Any other discussion? Agenda items? Okay, we're going to discussion resolution to approval for to pay the bills. Any motion on the second?
Nathan.
Jim made it.
Second.
And Mel second. And Diana, have you read it?
Resolution authorizing the post audit payment of certain claims, bills, and invoices of the town. Whereas the town board has reviewed and audited the following claims, bills, and invoices for services rendered and goods provided to the town in April of 2018. From Town of Crewe vouchers number 2018-00420 and including 2018-00566, abstract dated 4/23/2018, for the dollar amount totaling $209,510.43 of that $24,548.92 was wired, and $184,961.51 is remaining to be paid. Whereas the town board finds said claims, bills, and invoices to be acceptable in form and reasonable in amount. Now therefore be it resolved that payment of the aforementioned claims, bills, and invoices is approved, and the supervisor be and hereby is authorized to make such payment, and be it further resolved that this resolution shall take effect immediately. And Mr. Douglas?
Yes.
And Mr. Irwin?
Yes.
And Mr. McDonald?
Yes. All three yeses, it passes.
Number 14, we're going to adjourn to executive session to discuss work history of an individual. I'm going to need a motion and a second for that. Jim made the motion.
I'll second.
And another second. And after this meeting, there will be nothing that will come out of there that we will be moving forward on. So there will be no decision made when we come out of there. So you don't have to stick around for anything. There will be no decision coming out of there. Thank you.